Yo, what's up, everybody?
Mooney what's up? Thank you for contributing.
What's up, everybody? Oh my god.
Mooney what's up? Thank you for contributing.
What's up, everybody? Oh my god.
Look who's not awake. Wow, we are so close. Did we just hit? Did we just hit the community goal? I can't tell. Oh my god. We did. Hey, thank you for the contribution, Mooney Z. Hey, we just hit the community goal. Congrats. Thank you, everybody. That's so awesome. Hey, what's up? I'm congrats. Thank you so much, Mooney. Opera LC, how you doing today? I'm an Eminem Z. Hey, hello, I'm Creepy. So what happened is I put up a community goal. If we were to hit 100,000 rupees in 30 days, we would start doing a Shadow of the Tomb Raider playthrough with me in cosplay as Jonah. Closet cosplay, I should say. And so I'm going to start playing that over the next week. Is Earl still asleep? 9. Oh, okay. I was going to say, yes, Earl is still asleep. But yeah. Awesome. So I guess Shadow of the Tomb Raider is going to be our next Tuesday-Saturday game. Or Tuesday-Sunday. As I figure this out really quick. For some reason, Firewatch stopped capturing the last time in the same way it did last time. So, my brain is gone. For sure. Excited. So I guess we'll start that on this Tuesday, and then we'll do Saturday or Sunday. Yeah, I think that's gonna take about like four sessions or so. Earl is definitely still sleeping. Earl. Earl stayed up too late last night because he didn't want to go to sleep for some reason. And now he's suffering for it. man. Thank you, everybody. Thank you for contributing those points over the last 7 days. So I had that goal set for 30 days, and it took y'all 7 days to complete it. Wow. That's pretty amazing. What was I gonna do? But yeah, thank you, everybody. Wow. Super surprised, super grateful for that. So I'm gonna start working on a Jonah closet cosplay. It's probably going to be Jonah from the first game, because I think I have stuff for most of that. Maybe if I can figure out one for Shadow. I don't think I have any of that stuff, anything like that even looks like it. But if I do, I will make it happen. Cool. There's that. And then we'll go back here. Hey, what's up, Dirty Wet Napkin? I've had like 5 cups of coffee and I'm still half asleep. That's fair. That's me. So I was gonna say like how I fell asleep through, I mean, I slept through my alarm. So I had an extra hour of sleep. Whew, 100k goal. Yes. So my alarm, I have an app on my phone called Extreme Alarm or something like that, and basically what has to happen for me to turn the alarm off is I have to do some math problems. So, and they're not that hard. I mean, the hardest they get will be like, you know, 15 times 10 or 15 times 9, 15 times 12 or something like that. And then I hate coffee. I'm not a coffee drinker either, but like I know it helps a lot of people. Wake up. So I have to do three of those to turn it off. And what happened this morning is alarm went off. I looked at it. I did the math problems, I guess, and I went. I just slept through it. Yeah. I was watching and I found the fire. It's behind you. You won the game. Does anybody see fire? I see fire, I see rain. But yes. Let me just drop a notification in the socials and we can get started. Twitch.tv/ what is my name? Really be good. There it is. Good song. So, fire! Shall we run in circles in panic mode? Yes. So, I see fire burn in the mountains. Oh, I don't know that one. when? You mean, run around in circles like we did during the Pots and Pan Geekery cooking stream? I should clip that. The first time the alarm goes off. And I literally run around like, what do I do? I didn't think people actually did that until I did it myself. Alright, here we are. Alright, post social media, done. Twitter. I see fire, I see rain. How's everybody doing today? Did everybody have a good Halloween? Thank you for the Hydrate Opera. Shout out Panda Geekery, thank you for the shout. Always run in circles. That fire can't be safe behind you for your place. Oh yeah, totally right. This is actually remnants of my my digital Halloween costume from yesterday. Why did I get tagged in this? Anyway, awesome, put the horn. I wanted to get a bit productive, so I kind of had a bit off the... oh, nice. You discovered that new point redemption pretty quick. It's at the top of the row now. Yo, yeah, this is my Halloween costume from yesterday. I don't really have anything to wear to go with the horns, but that's why I put fire behind me. Kind of completes the look, don't you think? All right, folks, it is the very first redemption. All right, let's do this. I kind of remember, or was, right? I kind of remember where we were, but let's see here. sure the game will tell me or something. Discord, thank you. Oh, I like to walk around games now. I've always kind of liked to walk around games.
This receiver just picked something up.
But yeah,
I've been getting into these lately again.
I found a device that picks up frequencies. It's how I found the reports last night, and it's going off now.
It just picked up a frequency?
Yeah, what could it be?
She's so...
I don't know. You gotta find out.
All right, I'm on my way now.
You know what I just picked up?
No.
A fifth of Major Bueno tequila from the creek.
Are you drunk?
No! I am getting drunk!
Hey, Dee, I don't want to harsh your vibe, but maybe, just maybe, that's a bad idea.
Henry, Henry, Henry.
What?
You're harsh in my vibe.
She's a little sus.
My thinking is I could stay up all night worried I'm gonna lose my job because of the side fire, or I could not worry and let the chips fall where they may. It's not like there's any proof we were down there.
My thinking is I'm gonna follow this wave receiver.
Ooh, I like it when you think.
Ay, ay, ay. I'll just leave you alone with whatever these thoughts are.
Sissy Jones won an award for her role as Delilah. Oh, I can see that. BAFTA. Is she British? Hey there, Delilah, what's it like in New York City? Delilah has chips. Ooh. I want chips. Where are you leading me? Oh, she was, yeah, that's right. Well, I haven't played all of The Walking Dead, so I probably don't know the character, but... yeah, she was, Joyce. In Life is Strange. I hope this game doesn't end up as sad as Life is Strange. Oh my gosh. Yo, Wino Gamers. What's it like in New York City? Girl, you look so pretty as yes, you do. I'm as quick and shine as bright as you. It's up there. I don't even get up there. Let's see if I can get around. Get around, 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 I get around. Let's go, Henry. Alright, see you in a little bit, Opera. Thanks for stopping by. See you in a little bit. Yo, what's this? It's a backpack. Yes. Strange backpack. Inspect you.
Shit!
Oh, shit!
What? Ah!
Hello? Out of me. Well, let's see,
I found some sort of supply bag. Light camping gear, some clothes, and basics. But it was alarmed. I think that's what was making the receiver go haywire.
You're okay? It's not a trap or anything?
Yeah, I'm fine. But there's also a set of keys here. I don't know why they'd be hidden out here. They say Shoshone
National
Forest,
that's what I did to my alarm this morning.
452. Is that the one in the canyon?
Yeah, it is. Who the hell took them?
And what the hell is in that cave?
Okay, let's just think.
Says the woman with a half a bottle of tequila in her belly.
Maybe they're panicking and we're preparing to beat it. The fire has them spooked and we have new walkie-talkies, so we have the upper hand.
Yeah, well, it's hard to feel like you have the upper hand when you're standing in the dark in the middle of the woods.
Oh. Well, you're back in your tower. Maybe you need a drink, too.
I'm not in my tower.
I am looking at a man standing in your lookout. And it's not you?
It is not me.
Oh my god, go.
I'm going.
What kind of ball suck did you get there? What was the map again? I can't. Okay. I have to go. I'm going right way. Go. This. Not that. God dang it. God dang it, Bobby. I think this is east. I think this is west. No. That's. Where's my compass? Do I just use this as a compass now? I guess. Okay. Oh no. Maybe. Hello, are you creep? Are you in the lookout tower?
Hey, is that person still up there?
No, he's gone.
All right, I'm close. I just didn't want to run into him. I'll call you when I get up there.
Creepy much?
I don't see anyone up here.
He was just there.
What am I supposed to do? I am definitely back at the lookout. She does that. Yeah, she does do that on the regular, kind of. She can see. Where is her tower? Her tower is right over. Whoa! So her tower is right over there. If you can see that. Okay, I'm back at my tower. And nothing is happening. What's that on my door? Oh. Thank you. Thanks, Warcry. How are you doing today?
Talking down at the site. Sounds like it was recorded from somewhere nearby.
Good, tired.
Oh, Jesus.
The darn time change. Brutal, right?
It sounds like we were the ones who burned it down and that it was your idea.
No.
We are screwed.
No!
Dee, just don't freak out, okay? Don't freak out.
Oh my God, what the fuck is happening, Henry?
Wow, that sobered her up real quick.
Morning and said that I knew what caused the Wapiti Meadow fire. So, I just got off the horn with that lookout who's wondering what I know, or that I'm an arsonist, or that I'm fucking losing it. Furthermore, I
don't
bet
freak
you
out.
Don't have the only tape of us from last night, so someone has evidence to back it up. We need to find out what someone's been keeping in that cave.
I'm going down there now.
We don't have a lot of time left out here, and if we don't find some fucking answers, when they lift us out of here, it's gonna be in handcuffs.
Oops.
We have to stick together, okay? Keep our story straight. From the first day with those girls to the person breaking in on our conversation, everything. We gotta be honest and consistent.
Yeah. I suppose you're right.
I know.
What's in the desk drawer? I never opened this. Ate the hard way. Alright. That is a cassette tape. Yo, Tiny Stella, thank you for the follow. How you doing today? Okay, I guess we are going to go to that creepy cave. Dang, this fire is getting hella close. Thank you for the follow. Alright, I kinda don't remember where anything is. So, Two Forks, the cave is in Thunder Canyon, right? But there's a shortcut from my place. Oh, there it is. Okay, so west and then north. Or east and then north. I keep on doing that. Making sure I'm on the right path. Oops. I'm just hauling some butt. What do you think is in this cave, y'all?
Hey, you... You didn't actually make that call.
No!
Right?
What the F?
To the other lookout. It just stuck in my craw. I let myself imagine how fucked I would be if you'd been lying to me. But now that I asked, I kinda just wish I hadn't.
I don't even know how to call anyone other than you. And please, rest assured, I would have found someone with a better sense of humor a long time ago.
Okay. Thanks.
Bats. Ooh. Well, here we go. Shit's about to get realer. Dun dun dun! Na 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 Batman! I know, we're about to spelunk.
What the hell?
Why did that happen? What? No, come on. Did you leave the key out here? Can't unlock from this side.
Delilah, someone locked me in the cave. Is this thing working? Delilah! Send someone to the cave, please! Can't get any damn reception.
None of this is good. I know, super aggressive with that key. Know what I'm saying? This guy. Alright. I guess there's only...
We must face the long dark of
Moria. Jesus, this is a big cave.
Claustrophobia. Oh, this feels weird. Delilah is sus. I know. It's super dangerous. DL Miller. What's
it's
up?
Freezing in
How
here.
You doing? Oh, the cave. Burn up in wood and watch her die in a cave. Yeah, those are our options right now. Can I... Got some sun here. Can I climb this? Anything? No, no. Okay. I didn't want to do that. Times Square can't shine as bright as you. It's not as sus as you. Hey, little Lila, why you sus all the time? You're drunk half the time I talk to you. Oh ho. Daylight.
Hey, are you there?
Yeah, what is it? What did you find?
Nothing yet, because someone tried to trap me in there.
This
you
is gonna
saw
get
someone?
A tetanus shot.
No, someone slammed the gate behind me and then ran away. I found another way out, but if I hadn't, Jesus!
So you didn't find anything?
No. There's a spot where someone had sunk an anchor, but the hardware's gone now.
I don't have any climbing equipment.
I just have my ropes.
What
is
this?
I'm gonna hike back to Two Forks and see if I can find anything that could double as an anchor to use in the spot.
Well, that doesn't sound dangerous.
Delilah, I just found an outcropping that someone was using as a little fort. I think it was Brian Goodwin.
Really?
Yeah, he built himself a real castle.
He made it! Ooh, a dinosaur. That's like an Allosaurus, okay, maybe? It's not quite a T-Rex. Maybe it isn't supposed to be a T-Rex. The Goodwins. Oh, maybe it's Brian Goodwin.
He was in the middle of really sprucing up the joint when they left.
Hey, look at that.
There's a ham radio schematic here, something Brian was working on.
Yeah, I think that was the one thing Ned did do with him. You know, tinkering on stuff like that.
Sweet. Ooh, video game toy. What is it?
There's a busted old toy out here, some sort of electronic game.
Yeah? I like Pong.
Everybody likes Pong.
Gosh, Brian had everything he loved out there.
It's a little weird that he'd just leave so much of his stuff out here.
Yeah, just a little
maybe
weird.
Maybe they were in a hurry when they left. Like I said, he wasn't supposed to be out here.
Yeah.
They almost got busted. Brian liked to go out on the railing of the tower and wave at the planes that dump water on fires, and... I got a call because someone thought a kid was up in Two Forks. I lied.
Thanks for the alert, dude.
Said it was Ned. If I ratted him out, they would have been forced to leave, and... I don't know, I guess I just felt like I was saving him from whatever shitty life Ned was gonna bring him back to. Not that it ended up mattering.
Yeah, it kinda does look like an old school Game Boy. With, like, the bottom cut off. It's like an LCD, one of those old Tiger games. I don't know if anybody has had one of those. Let's put everything into a pile. Wizards and Wyvern sheet. Nice.
There's some grade A dork contraband here.
You found his pocket protector?
I found a data sheet for one Gladius Silva, half-elf, armor 7.
That's it?
Classic Wizards and Wyverns.
Tiger games, haven't played one of those in ages. Yeah, same. I had, Castlevania 2 that I would bring with me, like, on all the camping trips. This is, you know, before Game Boys. Well, I had a Game Boy at the time, but, like, I played my Game Boy so much that one day, I remember I was sitting in the backseat in my mom's car playing either Tetris or Super Mario Land, and I just hear the batteries go pop, and the batteries popped in my Game Boy and leaked all over the PCB, and that was it for that Game Boy. Yo, words from Ruben, what's up? Rhino Tiger Games, right? I wonder how much, if you found those, how much it would like go for on eBay these days. Wizards and Wyverns. Let's take a look at this character sheet. Gladius Silver, Chaotic Good, Half-Elf, Ranger, level 4. Gladius. Male, age 29. That's pretty young for an elf. Height, 5'8", weight 135, appearance, rugged. Hair, black-blue. Eyes, blue-green, clan, homeworld. Unintelligible nerd stuff. This has been the second game that there's been a D&D reference in. No, second. Unintelligible nerd stuff, for real, right? I'm gonna keep this because I'm a nerd.
Huh, Brian stole his dad's climbing gear, his anchors.
That's convenient.
Yeah, it is. I think he was gonna hide them in a cash box or something and never got around to it. I mean, he left a note for a ranger to find them and send them back to him in Nebraska.
Because he hated climbing?
Yeah, it sounds like Ned was pushing him, and pretending to lose his anchors was the easiest way to put a stop to it.
I hope it worked. God, what an asshole.
Yeah. Man, that is the sort of thing that would have caused me to catch a beating growing up.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't put it past old Ned.
My name is Brian Goodwin. If you found this note, it could be a bunch of climbing anchors. With a bunch of climbing anchors, I hope. Could you do me a favor and please return them to me, Brian Goodwin, in the mail. My address is 55 Foxtrot Lane, North Platte, Nebraska. If you tell me your name and address, I'll give you a reward for this. You're probably wondering why I left these here. Well, they are my dad's, and I don't want him to lose them, but I don't want to do any reclaiming. Thank you, Ranger, Brian. The reward will be good. You just found that Cheese Donut video on Facebook. Probably will share it later. Nice. That Cheese Donut video. You mean the one that we watched last night? Oh, yo.
There's also a postcard here from Brian to, I guess, his neighbor.
What's it say?
That he's with his dad and sorry he can't mow his lawn this summer.
Oh, gosh.
And also he was worried his dad didn't know when school started. I'd say that's a lucky break if I were him.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. Ned didn't really seem like a, you know, with it dad.
Thanks. You know, right? Those cooking videos. If I had a working... Dude. I totally want to make... If I had like a deep fryer? No. It's a lot. Even with a deep fryer, you would need to... God, now that guy used like a wok, but that's like a lot of oil. Let's read this. I'm with my dad in Lander, Wyoming. It's pretty neat. Dad fished a spot called Sinks Canyon. Most of Wyoming looks like home in Nebraska, but then there are mountains and woods when you go far. I'm sorry I can't mow your lawn this summer, but I hope you find a good person to do it instead. Can you write back and tell my dad when school starts? Because I don't think he knows your friend and neighbor, Brian Goodwin. Mr. Zackler. What a name. North. Is Brian the one doing all this reading?
Bunch of rocks stacked up. You made a wall and a perimeter.
God. Yeah, that's perfect.
You know, maybe he made it because he was afraid of them.
Whenever I think of Brian possibly going through this crap, I get sick to my stomach.
Yeah. Sorry.
Them. Anything else you got here? School folder. Oh, shit. Is that the schoolwork?
I found an old school folder. Brian was a hell of a doodler.
Yo, is that straight up, it's a peachy folder? Brian Goodwin, the Draculords. Gladius Silva. You're dead. That's definitely Freddy. It's a peachy, yep. I like the Draculords. Oh my gosh. That's pretty good. I'm just keeping everything.
Brian was doing a science fair project about bouncing radio waves off of a meteor shower.
Interesting.
Poor kid left his homework?
Yeah. He must have been pretty smart, huh?
Yeah, sharper than a lot of the grown-up knuckleheads I'm used to, yeah.
What, you're saying I'm one of those knuckleheads, is that it?
I wasn't, but, now that I think about it...
Because I know lots of stuff.
Oh, please, drown me in your surplus of knowledge.
Thank you for the hydrating.
I've been waiting all these years for a man as wise as you to take this job.
Well, that wait's over, sweetheart.
Call me sweetheart again, and you'll use that big sexy brain of yours to fill out your unemployment paperwork.
Sorry, boss.
rough drafts. How ham radio waves can use meteors to talk to people far away. What if I told you you could use meteors in our atmosphere to talk to people far away? Dude, Flight of the Navigator. Have you seen that? Do you all remember that in the movie? Compliance. Meteors, the alien rocks that come to our planet from outer space, can be used to bounce ham radio waves off of and let you use your radio much better than normal. Right now you're thinking, okay, Brian, this sounds like a movie like Flight of the Navigator. It's not real. But you are wrong. It is real. It is science. Classic. Yeah, it's an old one. I don't even remember how... I remember watching it. I must have been like 5 or 6 or something like that. You haven't watched the Dirty Wet Napkin? I don't know where. I'm sure it's on the internet somewhere, but like, it's about this kid who discovers a UFO. And he gets aboard it, and it time travels, and all this cool stuff. So, yeah. But you definitely may remember it, yeah. Bring back all kinds of memories on this stream. And it's this game.
Hey, remember that pack I found?
Back on your second day? Yeah.
I found a plan Brian drew about how he was going to get it back.
Oh, wow.
Oh, I'm sure it was quite elaborate.
It's some
crane.
Wile E. Coyote stuff, I'll tell you that much.
Jeez.
He made the place pretty comfy, too.
That's an achievement.
Yeah, at the expense of what are probably stolen pillows.
That little shit.
Poor Brian Goodwin. What'll happen to this kid? You do not have an arm, my friend. Okay, I think we've explored all we could. Let's head back. Actually, we can head back to the cave, right? We have pit and anchors. Yeet! Oh, you're right. Flight of is probably, yeah, most likely on Disney Plus. Came out in 86. Nice. You were 4. Yo, Jamar, what's up, brother? How is you doing? Where is the entrance to the cave now? Oh, didn't I jump down something? I don't know if I could get back up this way. I probably have to, yeah, go around. Jeez. Hello, map. Kid from that movie grew up and robbed a bank? Oh man. That's never fun hearing that stuff. That's like, I can't think of anybody off the top of my head. Like one of the kids who played Crab, one of them, Crab and Goyle, in Harry Potter. One of them did something bad. I know. Child stars from the 80s, you know, lots of tragic stories there. Kimberly from Different Strokes. Can't think of anything else. But yeah, there's a lot. It's kind of crazy, I don't know. It's probably just Crab, he was involved in a riot, I think. Oh. There's always that thing, you know? If you were a child star, there's like this... I don't want to say stereotype. I guess it's kind of a stereotype, but... The things went all wrong for you after, you know, you couldn't cope with being back in the real world. I guess it makes sense. It's kind of tough. If you don't have, like a good anchor... Like, real world-wise, it's gonna be hard to, like, step out of this fantasy world after, you know? I mean, it happens with, like, adult actors. Even. River Phoenix, yeah. That's a good one. I was just talking to, Oddball about River Phoenix. Because, I forgot. I owe all his brother, Joaquin, and, Who's his wife? Gosh, what is her name? They just had a child and named him River, which is like, aww. The Corys. I don't remember the Corys. What show were they on? I think I'm just gonna try to get around. I don't think there's a way for me to get back up here. Is there one more look? The only Corey I can think of is James S.A. Corey, but that's not a real person. It's just a pen name. Okay, yeah, I don't think there's a way. Let's go around. Oh, were they? Are they brothers? Corey Haim and Corey Feldman. Yes, I know those Corys quite well. I mean, Lost Boys. It's a classic. It is a lot of families stealing money from them. I think that's
why
they...
What do you think is in there?
I don't know, really. I mean, we gotta find out. What do you think?
Whatever it is, they don't want you telling anyone about.
I mean, they closed the door when they could have just...
bashed your head in with a rock or chopped you up with a...
Are you serious with this shit right now?
A hatchet. God, are you sure you want to go back in there?
No, I think I'm probably good. Bring on jail.
You'd probably just get probation. I'd be the one stuffed away in the Lusk women's prison for the next 10 years.
I knew... where the exit was, but really I didn't want to say anything. That's all good.
Also, those girls turned up. Looks like you didn't kill them. Nobody did.
Woo.
They took some farmer's tractor for a joyride down in Riverton and, landed in jail.
Dodged a bullet there.
Yeah, we've got enough unanswered shit to answer for, I'd say.
This music is so peaceful. Nice leisurely stroll through, There we go. Yeah, kind of low-key ominous. Okay. So aggressive. Walking backwards through a cave is a bad idea. I wonder if it's gonna slam on me again. Guess not. I'ma punch this gate! I don't know if I would actually do this in real life. This is kind of crazy. Is there an anchor point? Nope, I'm just gonna drop. Yeah, totally creepy vibes. What are we gonna find down here? And there goes the music. Yo, stuff. Yeah, I know, this would be kind of scary to do by yourself. No, is that a body?
Oh, God. You're Brian Goodwin.
Crypto Castle. That's sad as fuck.
You fell.
Thinking you'd be able to slide down the rocks Uncharted style. I did that once and I ripped my pants up pretty badly. I didn't notice that my pants were ripped until I was like, why does it feel breezy? The seat of my pants was like ripped straight open. Oh, Brian Goodwin. How fucking sad.
Stuff gave out. Oh, you poor fucking kid.
Story time with Earl. I know. Lots of camping stories. I'm sure Jamar here has lots of camping stories. Probably both of them. You know. A lot of stories with us, both of us involved. Yeah, that's the boy. Unfortunately. Oh man. What a maze. Oh, footholds. It's all about the wilderness survival shelter. Totally, dude. So back when me and Jamar here were Boy Scouts, we would go up to this weekly scout camp, a yearly scout camp that was a week long in the Angeles National Forest called Camp Tockwitz. And it wasn't like exactly roughing it because there were like still bathrooms and stuff. But you know, for the entire week you slept in the tent and cooked your own food and you hung your bear bags up and all that. You just didn't have to dig a latrine.
Hey, Dee.
There you are. I've been worrying my ass off.
You need to call search and rescue.
What?
There's a body in the cave. It's Brian Goodwin.
Gotta be fucking kidding me. How does that... What? I don't... How?
Climbing, I think, or made to look like a climbing accident. I think that's just what it was. I mean, he was probably exploring the cave and maybe his rope gave out. But whoever locked me in there probably didn't even know about him. I'm sorry, Delilah. I'm so sorry.
He'd be alive if I had told someone he was out here. I don't know where he'd be, but I can assure you it would not be rotting at the bottom of that cave. There's nothing to say. Hike back. I think we're leaving tomorrow anyway.
Jeez. So anyway, I was saying that yearly scout camp, that was week long, and part of it was like you were there to do a lot of scout stuff, and including like classes for merit badge, one of them being wilderness survival. So that's what we did.
You see that plane?
No, I was just busy packing up.
Well, there's gonna be a lot more. The service says this thing is 2% contained.
2%?
Is this the Flapjack fire, or the site fire, or...?
Well, the two fires merged into one unmitigated disaster. They're renaming it after my lookout.
Yikes.
You about packed up?
Shouldn't we talk for a sec? You know, about things.
About what?
About what happened to Brian.
I don't have much to say. I'm fine. I'm sad. I'm whatever. I keep thinking about him down there, and I just want to get far away from here.
What can I do?
We just have to wait for the helicopters.
Okay.
Until then, could you follow that signal? Maybe?
Holy crap. Yeah, oh my god.
We don't know what it is. It could be nothing.
Yeah, it could also be whoever was listening to us, whoever made the tape.
Okay, yeah, look, you should pack up everything you need in case we get the call and you can't come back.
Alright, look, if something happens...
I'll remember you.
So anyway, let me finish this, because it feels weird not finishing this, but, Wilderness Survival being one of the merit badges, and one of the things that we had to do to complete the merit badge was we had to build a shelter out of, like, this, the, you know, any natural flora and, like, rocks or whatever that we could find in the forest, and we had to sleep in it overnight. And they would come and they would check, like, to see if we built a shelter that was survivable for a certain amount of time. But yeah. That's it, and we all got our Wilderness Survival Merit Badges. We catch up on chat really quick. Well, what's your favorite part about this game so far? I really like the exploring, and you know, just like walking around, looking at the cool stuff. Yeah, the exploring part is really good. I would totally do this with other people. Yeah, I would love to do this again. It's been so long for me. If I didn't have the balance of a toddler and an aversion to heights, I might have gone camping. Yeah, that's fair. Those are two very, very, very important things to take care of. I am watching The Mandalorian, so I watched the first episode as soon as it came out. Well, not as soon as it came out, but Thursday night. So as soon as it dropped, I checked to make sure it was there, like around midnight, and then it was there. And I watched it around 3 in the morning or so. Yeah, that was interesting. I mean, I had a lot of fun. I'm trying not to say things because I know people might not have watched it. This looks intense. It is getting intense. Oh, yeah, you missed the body, Sorrel. Sorry. Remember that song, Pass the Toilet? I don't think I know that one.
I was hoping you'd have a backup plan or something.
I was going to say, how does that go? But I don't know how you could convey that to me.
I'm probably going to move to Canada. Ontario, maybe.
No, I meant if something happens to me.
Right, if you don't find out who made the tape and I have to hit the road.
Forget it.
Be safe, Henry.
All right, Is there anything I need? Supplies from Two Forks. That's a lot of stuff he hasn't eaten. Keep that. That is mine. Toilet paper. I just remember because of TP in the background got it. Yeah, I don't remember how it goes. I'm not sure I know it. Unforge. I like that Gus from Breaking Good. Oh, and Blossip. Oh, yeah, yeah. As, what's your name? Moff Gideon. You see, pass the toilet paper over and over. Right. Okay. I'm gonna look that up later. Yeah, he's totally badass in at the end of Mandalorian Season 1. And, I mean, that's a big question, right? How does he have the Darksaber? Oh, yeah, I'm using this thing. No. No. Yes. Oh, it's kind of hard to see the... Which one? Oh, there it goes. I feel like I'm really close to the fire. This is, has to be dangerous. Yeah, definitely, Giancarlo Esposito's great. He's an amazing actor. California totally looked like this for like a week. Because of the wildfires. A lot less wind. But the orange is very accurate, real.
What's your status?
I think I'm getting close.
All right, well, I just got word that they are coming to get us. My place.
You sound worried.
No, it's just...
Brian?
I'll coordinate with the evac team and let you know when to head towards the tram. It's north. Far. Past where you found that cut back in May. There's an emergency tram out there that will let you hike to the rendezvous point at my lookout.
Hmm. This is bringing back wildfire memories. It's always rough. Nope. What is this called? Wildfires, yeah. Wildfires, that is it. Saw pictures from the wildfires, it sounds so scary. It's, yeah. I mean, yeah, it sucks, Mooney. It's, you know... They say, like, here in California, we have two seasons. It's warm and then, like, fire season, basically. What?
Someone left a rope for me to climb up. I'm down near the lake.
How How do you know it's for you?
There's a tracking collar tied to it. Someone was leading me here. And there's another tape.
Oh my God, Henry.
What the hell? Goodwin.
I've been up here for 3 years. I kept it cozy. Winters are harsh as hell, and I ran out of books. But I got that antenna rigged up, and Delilah, she's a record you don't gotta flip. I kinda get why Brian took to her. About a week ago, I stopped worrying about you finding anything out, and that's right when everything went shithouse with you two.
What?
You guys don't know anything about having kids. All right, nobody knows nothing. It ain't Andy and Opie walking down a lake to fish every afternoon. It ain't Mayberry. But you gotta know I didn't kill him. All right, we were climbing. I was teaching him. Brian was uneducated in the way to do anything. He just fucking didn't sink his anchor the right way. Jeez. You know, I thought about going back, having to answer questions and having to get him put in the ground, and I didn't see the point. Don't come looking for me. Sorry about your wife.
We found the surveillance operation.
Okay, what does that mean? What is it?
It was Ned Goodwin. He was the one listening to us, just him.
Tape?
Yeah.
Do I think there should be more action in the Mandalorian?
Deeper into the Shoshone. He doesn't want anyone to know he's out here.
No, I think it's fine.
Because he killed Brian. Because he killed his fucking son.
I like the slow pacing of the Mandalorian.
You need to get back here. They say the helicopters are making rounds.
Okay.
But... yeah, I don't think the Mandalorian... I appreciate the pacing and the... because it can't be all action, you know? We've got to sit here and figure out who the Mandalorian is. And that's more interesting stuff to me anyway. Is all that stuff. The world building and... the mystery of who he was in the first game. Or the first season. But also who the child is. That's such a big mystery. You know, and I hope we do find out... if you think about it, that the mystery of the child is bigger than just the Mandalorian itself. It's about, you know, the mysterious race of who Yoda, that race. Because, you know, we've seen what... there's Yoda, there's Yaddle, and then there's this kid. And what their origins are, and, you know, all that stuff. So that's going to be interesting to see what they reveal there. If they reveal anything, really.
I guess he's been dumping trash up here for a while.
He thought you'd find Brian and report him, right? Looks so... it's kind of open-worldy. But, I think it's a pretty small canyon, honestly. Otherwise, yeah. Is he ever gonna take off his mask? I mean, I don't think he will. That's just the whole thing about the Mandalorian, right? He took off his mask at the end of season one. But... so that's not so much of a mystery anymore. Like, what? If he takes it off, I'm pretty sure the second time he does, he's gonna be dead. The Mandalorian. He's John DeLorean, no mystery about that. Right. Look at this. He's been stealing lookout supplies. Got a coal. Coleman, like, camp stove. Where does he get this? Oh, wait, it's cooking supplies. Probably.
Goodwin was the one who wrote the reports I found at the site.
What was that site, though? Delilah, 43. Charismatic, selfish. Skewed perception of personal history. Britain was never my fuck.
He wrote down everything he did to us, and everything he did every day. He was scared shitless.
How to break in Wapiti North Fence. This is August 10th. Return barred equipment. Erase. Leave no trace.
I bet.
Yo. Let me switch these out. Yeah, I would love to have an underground hideout as well. Thank you for spending the channel points. Oh, I already read that. Old typewriter. Observational traits, fuck. Guilty. Okay. Oh, look at this. He's having a bad time here. Formatting. Maybe I should turn on my flashlight. I love coffee. I love the Java, and it loves me. Coffee and tea and the Java in me. A cup.
You should see some of the stuff he was working on. I guess he had a lot of time on his hands.
You're like 10k down since Causeway Girl. Oh, thanks, Mooney. It's been a while since I've seen a percolator, right?
This boombox looks familiar.
The girl's boombox, maybe. Look at his battery bank, yeah.
He was rigging up stolen batteries to keep his stuff going.
He didn't have any way to, like, recharge them, though. Well, unless he was doing something here. Electronic junk. Winter needs 1989, 2,000 ounces of propane, 300 buried, 25 books, 90 amp hours of battery power, new boots. Try elk skin. Summer weight gain goal, 35 pounds. That's a lot. It's time for the percolator. 89 is the year you started elementary. Nice. 89 is the year Batman came out. In my head, right? Michael Keaton Batman. Oh, this guy, he's the one who wrecked the girls' camp.
He... God.
What?
Nothing, just some of Brian's stuff.
I'm sorry. I don't know what to say. I don't know what you want me to say. We're in the middle of a fire that is at 22,000 acres and growing. Fast.
It's gonna burn all of this up.
Well, take a picture if you're so keen to remember it.
You're not?
I don't know.
Who's gonna take it?
Brian was a nice looking kid.
Teen magazines. Alright, let's let's check out what was over here.
He had quite the view. He's got a radio base station up here. He was listening to us on that.
I remember being a bit scared by that movie. We saw it at a drive-in. Gosh, I want to go to a drive-in. Some Mama Grizzly morning hike. Surprised we haven't run into any animals. Saw 2F. Henry is 2F. Saw 2F coming out of cave. D calling for hiker's list. Delay her, she'll forget. Never been to a drive-in, but there used to be one not too far from your house. D never called for a hiker list. 2F hiked by cave. Seems interested, less interested. 2F, Jules, Julian, Julia. 2F is a good guy. Haven't seen Mama Grizz in 2 months. D drunk again. Get a room. Reminder, scout migration due to fire. 7 fucked up. Do not want to leave. Hide supplies for migration. D and 2F suspect conspiracy. Funny, if not dire. Observe ready to leave. Reports. Oh, wow. Pit against each other. Look at this guy. Trying to Machiavelli this. Machiavelli. Stakes too high. No one will believe B was happy, Brian. Make D and 2F less believable. 2F crazy. Like, why if not good guy? Mama Grizz back. They heard me. Fully believe there's a program. Use this. Reports final. Make sure they find them. Caught me outside. Reports. Record a call is used for leverage. 2F found supplies. How? Key's gone. Can't let 2F find B. Ooh. But I did, punk. Alright, we should probably get out of here. Or something. Hike the North Thoroughfare. Okay, I am here. I need to get to a... Alright. Trail. So head south. Let's go this way. Is there a fire? There is, yeah, definitely a fire. I'm in the middle of a wildfire right now. I'm just trying to look for a path that I can follow. That is not it. What fire? That's crazy talk. No, but yeah, Analog, there's a fire. Like, it's the two fires that started earlier in this game, and they've merged, apparently. So, things are dire. And we're about to get airlifted out if I can get to where I'm going. It's behind me. We didn't start the fire. Always burning since we were contending. We didn't start the fire. But we didn't light it. We're trying to fight it. Where am I? Okay, I just need to go a bit west, and then I'll hit a trail. Oh no. I hate when that happens. Hope they like figured that out. Okay, I kinda know where I am. This is the on my way to the lake.
I know I should be relieved. Relieved that there's no evidence of us starting that fire. Relieved that we're not crazy. That there wasn't some conspiracy. But I'm not. He was a sweet kid. With a shitty father who hid out here like a coward after dumping him in a hole.
Every time I think of that, it's SNL Ferguson sketch.
Lila, I think it was an accident.
I don't think I remember that one off the top of my head.
To kill him.
We don't know what happened for sure.
Ned wanted his son to be able to climb and do the sorts of things he did himself, but Brian couldn't.
And how'd that turn out, Henry? Sorry. God, it would have been so easy to tell the truth and have him sent home. I can't stop thinking about it.
You didn't do anything wrong.
Yes, I did. And now I've got to decide whether I tell people that he's down there so they can retrieve the body or not. And if I do, I'm going to be asked about Ned Goodwin.
D?
Oh, fuck.
Is that a helicopter?
Yeah, hold on.
Yes,
hey.
She...
No, there's one more. Yes, here, yeah. Yeah, he's coming. Okay, 1 second. Hey, they're here, but they're making rounds. They'll come back. I think I'm gonna go with them.
Wait, just wait, okay? I'm not that far.
Henry, they're here.
Thanks, Dio.
They're waiting right now.
Please.
Cece Jones won a BAFTA for this? Oh yeah, I think somebody mentioned that.
I don't want to meet you and just sit here in a dead boy's shadow. Okay, I don't want to do that. I know that sounds harsh. Okay, I'll wait.
I'm not far.
Okay.
I think I'm far. Kind of far. Alright, double time. Yeah, I hope that resolves somehow, Anwala. It could just be that, you know, maybe the server's bogged down or something. Hopefully it's not an access problem. But I'm sure if you... As long as you have, like, a receipt, it's gonna be... You know, you can show that to them. I'm sure they'll be able to help. Yo, Arcade Chris, I know I'm almost done. If I can get to where I need to go and don't get lost. I hate the ending to this game. Oh no. Get back to the trail back here. There's the Is there anything in here? I just want to know if there's like candy bar in here or something. Nothing good. All right, let's go. Let's talk about the ending. My friends are 50-50 after he's done, of course. Oh my gosh. Sad music. We're probably going to talk about this. I feel like this is a game where we're going to talk about the ending for a little bit. Okay. Right. Come on. Alright, let's go. Sad music. Driving yet ominous and sad. It's a nice kind of feel. We could probably know a command. I have to figure out how to like give the bot or get the bot a subscription. I like hugs though. What's crazy to me is that there is a, research site here that Dee didn't know about, which is kind of weird. Wait, am I supposed to go to Dee's tower? No. Thoroughfare lookout, okay.
Hey, I'm at the evac spot near the ravine. Delilah, are you there? Delilah?
I don't know what to put, actually. Because ideally it would be the emotes, right? Like an emote. How about let's hold off on the hug and then I'll create an emote. I'll switch out with one of the other emotes. I know rope burns after doing that for real.
Oh god, it's a nightmare out there. Hello? Delilah?
Damn it.
Hello? Is anybody there?
This is all her old, like, the proto-gamer headset.
Yeah, it's me.
And you're calling from where?
No. Don't be mad.
I'm not mad. I'm just...
You're not mad? You're just disappointed?
I'm not your dad after you got busted smoking pot.
I just couldn't be out there for another minute.
You could have just said that.
You really wanted me to stay.
I did. And now I'm...
disappointed.
Yeah.
I know. Hey, it shouldn't take long for the helicopter to reach you.
Okay.
There's a debrief in a situation like this. Lots of questions.
Look at this.
Shit.
Henry.
So, taking stock, we found out an old lookout killed his only son and decided to become a lonely hermit.
Yes.
And we prevented one fire?
Basically started another.
Okay, so that's a wash.
I'll have to figure out what I'm doing every summer from now on that isn't this.
You're not coming back?
No. And you'll have to... I don't know.
Yeah. Me neither. I don't know what's next.
Tell you what, why don't you choose for me, and I'll choose for you.
All right, sure. Maybe... maybe move to Santa Fe. Open a jade emporium with your sister.
I'd be trading cute ski bombs for yoga retreat hippies, but maybe that's not all bad.
What's the margarita situation?
I mean, yeah.
So what about me?
I think you should go to Julia, and then you can figure it out. Maybe put that typewriter to good use. Give me a sexy accent or something if you write about this.
Yeah.
You gotta go see her.
Would you?
Henry, I... look, you came out to put your memories behind you, and they're still right there in front of you.
You're right. I mean, I think you're right.
Good.
When I get back, maybe I could,
We shouldn't focus on this summer. Next year we'll roll around, and then the year after that, and then it's just a... I don't know. My Aunt Judy called it a pause in the hallway of time.
Did your Aunt Judy smoke a lot of pot?
Yeah?
Well, you should try to take her advice, too.
The pork pond side.
Yeah, we'll see.
There's the helicopter.
They'll land back where you hiked up. Good luck, Henry.
I'll see you when I see you.
Yeah, okay. Sounds good. Bye, Hank.
That was a no, you won't. I'm keeping that. Maybe the tequila, too. Warcry.
Something deep down in my soul said, cry, girl.
Oh, you missed a lot of the story. I'm all of that. Sorry. Is there, would you say there's like some, I don't know, people, bit song, people who have played this game, the song's great, yeah, would you say there's replay to this? There's definitely replay.
Most of all, I just don't wanna be free, no.
I just don't wanna be free, oh.
I was just.
Oh, that's right, Free Robo.
I was just sitting there thinking of your kiss and your warm embrace.
Of your warm embrace.
When the reflection in the glass that I hear.
makes the intro much more relevant than I remember commenting it was interesting that they didn't just start at the tower. Exactly. If they had started at the tower, that would have made this game about the conspiracy, about the tower itself, about, it would have been about Firewatch or about Landers, Wyoming. But it's not. It's about Henry. It's about Delilah. And all this other stuff, like where they are, where it's almost inconsequential. This could have taken place anywhere. So, I don't know. I dug it. The only outstanding thing I don't like is that there was all this buildup of whatever level relationship between you, and she just straight up lies and says she'll wait and doesn't. People not keeping their word really rubs me the wrong way. Yeah, that, I will say, that felt a little like, aww. But I almost wonder if that was purposeful on behalf of the developers. It was mostly about the pine cone in the first box. So a little Easter egg is that if you pick up the first pine cone, you unlock. No, I don't know. But yeah, the first pine cone is that if I ever develop a video game, it's gonna be that. That's gonna be like an Easter egg. Like, if you picked up that first pine cone, you get this ending. If not, then oh well. I think it was purposeful not to have a tidy ending, right? We don't now always have to get closure. That's very true. Oh, closure. It's weird because you know how they say, like, stories sometimes come to you in the time, in a part of life where it's going to be most relevant. And, like, this is kind of interesting because Firewatch, it's all about, it's kind of the isolation, which is, you know, what everybody's, a lot of people are going through right now. And, it's kind of weird. It's kind of the perfect game for quarantine. So what do we have in the special features here? Firewatch audio tour. Play the game. Ooh, what? Yo. We usually don't get closure in life, so we escape to art. This is true. I think I read that devs purposely didn't want D to be on screen. I feel the same way. I think if I was developing this game, you know, a part of the team that developed this game, I would not have D on screen, because, like, it's like the monster reveal in a horror movie, right? Or it's similar to it. You have all this buildup of who the person is, or what the reveal is going to be. When you finally see the monster, if they decide to reveal the monster, it better be fucking amazing. And if it's not, it's gonna fall short. I mean, like, whatever you do, the image that people build up in their minds of, like, what something could be is gonna, it's gonna be far above what you could present on screen, honestly. It's just how it's gonna be. And, so, like, if you decide to, like, present your mystery box and reveal it on screen, then, it's got to be amazing. If it's not, like, 100% on point, it's going to fall short. It's just going to fall short. And you see that even in small things, like, when, you know, I always think about in Beauty and the Beast. One of the things is, like, you think about, like, what is the beast going to look like when he transforms back to the prince, you know, the handsome prince. And when he actually transforms back into the prince, you're like, oh, that's it? That's the guy? Let's go back to being the beast. You're, like, way cooler. Yeah, nothing could have ever met expectations. So I'm glad they did that. You don't remember if you said this before, but Sissy Jones, the woman Delilah. Oh, yes. She also, Joyce in Life is Strange. Joyce? But yeah, she did great in this. I think I mentioned this in, like, the first session of this. Totally getting, like, Her vibes, you know, the Spike Jonze film. This man, like, this dude, like, falling in love with an idea, like a voice, a personality that you don't ever see. It's true. Yeah, so at first I left empty about how it ended, but I like the choice for the reasons you said. Yeah, absolutely. Sissy's cool. I get that. She played Chloe's mom. It was an okay game. Yeah, but yeah, this is chill. I do would probably... This is cool, Firewatch Audio Tour. Commentary with team. I love director commentary. Certain director commentary. Let's get a little taste of this. Oh, I can upload photos. Oh, I missed that. Let's look at the photos I took, actually. Can I even exit out of this? But yeah, I don't know. I mean, if this developer comes out with another game, Camp Santo, I totally would be open to playing that too. I thought I had turned on commentary. Same choices I see, I know. Let's take a look at the other one. I'm going to take the camera up, roll load. Oh, yeah. Uh-oh. Sorry, I can't give out my email address. You can see the edge of my green screen. Low adding. All right. Let's go see those pictures. I didn't actually take too many pictures. That's funny, you can order the prints though. The same choices I said. I was just clicking through. I was just clicking very instinctually. So I guess, yeah, creature of habit. So there's that one. And that one. No, this is the camp. I didn't take too many. I thought I took one of the... No, I didn't. I just took the postcard. Yeah, I would love to see this stuff IRL. It's been so long. Maybe I'll just fucking go. I haven't been outdoors in so long. Literally need to just buy, like, more gear, is what it is. Let's all go. Does everybody come to California? When does the commentary start? Yeah, I know. Channel camping trip. I just want to know what the commentary is like. Boulder, Colorado, 1975. Camping trip, meet and greet, I know. Bring your old marshmallow and stick. That's all you bring, though. It's just marshmallow and stick, nothing else. You are drunk. You're pretty. You're pretty, she says coolly. You are not. You are a future hangover. What? You reply confused. Someone should buy you a cheeseburger, she says. She flexed on a waiter, and 1 week later, you are Julia's boyfriend. Graham chat crackers and chocolate. Yeah, let's do the entire thing. Whole s'mores thing. Isn't there supposed to be commentary right now? I'm confused. Gameplay and presentation, hide interface brightness. You've never seen this part of the game before? I'll zoom in and lag out. Lag out immediately. I know, it sucks. It's so far. Even if we zoomed out there, like... if we had a access point, gosh. I don't know if we'd be able to... have sustainable internet. You date for over a year. She drives you absolutely nuts. It's great. You move in, you share an apartment near the school with a view of the mountains. You two drink beers out on the deck. You drink beer just about anywhere. Life is good. Julia wants to get a dog. There's a scruffy, undersized beagle. Julia is in love. She wants to bring it with her to class. There's also an intimidating but gentle-eyed German shepherd. Nothing bad could happen to Julio while walking his dog. It's badass. You adopt the shepherd and name him Mayhem. Mayhem's an excellent dog. He loves wrestling with you in the park and goes with Julia on her runs. Even though he's too big to bring to school, Julia loves him all the same. Mayhem is a friend, child, and pet all rolled into one. Aww. You talk out on the deck. It's summer, 9:30 p.m. and the heat still radiates off the high desert. What do you think about kids? She asks. Kids? They're not even smart. They're good at much. I'm saying if you and I have a couple of little... I'm saying if you and I have some, a couple of little idiots. One day. Why rush? She looks away, out toward the mountains. We have plenty of time, right? Speak for yourself, mister. Don't worry, you're sure. You tell her she has the body of an undergrad. My ovaries didn't get the memo, she says, laughing it off. One day, okay? Okay, one day, she says. 6 months later, you get engaged lying in bed on a Sunday morning. Jeez. waiting for this audio. This audio. Oh, here it goes. Oh, I love it. It's literally an audio tour. Like, have you ever been to a museum and they give you, like, a listening device? And it basically, you know, you can listen to an excerpt about, like, somebody speaking on a piece of art that you're looking at. It's pretty cool. I think I've only ever done that at the Guggenheim. But it was pretty awesome. Yeah, of course, now they're digital, yes.
Hi, I'm Sean Vanneman. I wrote the bulk of 100% of this game.
Hey, I'm Jake Rodkin. I did a lot of level design, UI design, and worked with everyone on the story for Firewatch.
The game has this weird structure that Chris and I talk about in another tape. This is the first thing I wrote, was this opening of the game that jumps between Henry's life and the trip out to the
both
woods.
100%,
and so. I used a little product called Twine to do that, which you Twine. Can download and use. It's just a very simple choose-your-own-adventure tool. The simplest way to program a video game that one can then share with friends and play.
We were worried that the team would sort of perceive Henry as a blank slate, as sort of a generic game player protagonist, and we wanted to make sure, or we wanted to get in everyone's mindset, you're playing as a specific guy with a specific life.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's a reason when you play video games that a lot of your protagonists have amnesia, because it's really difficult when you're driving a character around who knows things about their life, or his or her life, that you, who you ostensibly are that person, don't know. So, yeah, we kept trying to write an opening of the game that happened sort of like weeks into Henry's experience, and then quickly realized that it was like, well, why would he not be able to say X? Well, because his relationship with his wife is Y. So, but the player doesn't know that. Yeah. And this was the quickest way to get everybody on board, was to just take the thing that I wrote that answered the question, I think, for Jane and you at the beginning, which was like, who is Henry? And I would write these character profiles that were really bad. And then I went, what if I just let you play a thing? And then you can figure out who he is. And we held on to that until we had the idea to put into the game.
It means that when you're playing Firewatch and Henry and Delilah start talking about Henry's wife, you don't have to learn it through his dialogue, because you made the choices that brought him where he is today.
That is a good choice. It's a Thursday night and Julia is 4 hours late. She doesn't call. You're worried and getting angrier by the minute. She walks in after you've gone to bed. She's not quite drunk, but she's clearly been having a fun time. You fight when she gets between the sheets. You get mad. You call her an inconsiderate asshole. She tells you to fuck yourself and not to be such a baby. You call her selfish. She knows you mean it and it hurts her feelings. Julia likes to draw. She draws plants from her research. She draws all the places you go. She draws you. You frolic, and you frolic like a Victoria's Secret model. Julia was right. You are very pretty. Oh, that's cool. So this entire thing is going to be like a series of these tapes. Okay, I get it. I don't know if we're going to do another playthrough of this immediately, because we're going to start Shadow of the Tomb Raider. But
hi, it's Jake again.
Hey, I'm Chris Remo.
Oh, hey, Chris.
Hi there. I was a game designer and the music composer on Firewatch.
Nice.
So you're hearing now the first piece of interactive music that went into Firewatch, the first piece of music that actually
responds to what you're doing in the game?
Exactly, yeah. So this is a piece of music that's divided into technically 6 parts. And what's happening is, as you're playing through this introductory sequence, when you hit certain points in the narrative, it sends a signal to Wise, which is the name of the audio middleware we're using. And then when Wise gets that signal, it waits until the next sort of musically appropriate transition point, and then when it hits that, it smoothly transitions into the next section of music, and so it creates the effect
that
you're just listening to one big long piece of music that just happens to be timed very nicely to your playthrough.
It just happens to get sadder and sadder at the exact rate that your life gets sadder and sadder.
Yeah, exactly. This was a challenging process, both because I had no idea what the music should sound like, and also because it was the first interactive piece of music in the game, so the technical sort of just how does this work was also a part of it. But as it turned out, this music was changed. I mean, Jake, you may remember this. This music changed relatively little over the course of development.
Yeah,
I think
it started off as maybe three pieces and it expanded out to five over development. But other than that, it's one of the first things dropped in, shipped. Get ready to hear about that a lot on this commentary.
Alright, so I think this is where we're gonna... This is a good place to stop. But thank you everybody for being here. I'm gonna start a poll. We're gonna figure out where we're gonna raid. But, gosh, what a game. I'm definitely gonna play this again. I don't know if we're gonna do it on stream, but, so I'll probably do another playthrough. I just don't know when I'm going to do it. But we're going to be starting... thank you for posting all that stuff, socials. We're going to be starting Shadow of the Tomb Raider in the next week. Maybe Tuesday. Hopefully Tuesday. Am I going to play Little Hope? Should I play Little Hope? Also, I'm going to be planning some other stuff because it is November. It is my birth month. So, we're going to try to celebrate over the course of the month. I don't know exactly what we're going to do yet, but we're going to figure it out. And hopefully have a lot of fun in the process. Happy birth month! Thank you. I have not played Man of Medan. I've watched Cersei play Man of Medan. So I kind of know the general vibe of it. Can we order a Bigfoot pizza? I wish we could order a Bigfoot pizza. And do I have a P.O. box? Would love to send you a card. So I probably have to get one. I was thinking about getting one. I will let you know when that happens because I'm working on it. Trying to get a new P.O. box that's closer to me. Because my P.O. box now is like all the way in Long Beach and it's like way far. But I'll let you know. Okay, then don't play Little Hope, okay. But, because there's the After Dark stuff too, right? There's all that. Or not After Dark, what is that? Until Dawn? It's an anthology, got it. Maybe I'll look into it and see what's going on there. Beaver Tales, what is it? Oh, Beaver Tales is an anthology. There's a festival in town, it brings in folks from faraway places, want to try to throw some knife. Mayhem runs away. Ah, god damn it, Mayhem. You beat his goddamn face in, which is what I would try to do. Your arm gets cut up, but you beat the guy to a pulp. You don't feel very tough. Your eyes cry out before the cop. You cry your eyes up before the cops show up. You don't need to know what happens in Until Dawn, man, to know about Little Hope. Okay. I know, I thought Mayhem would fight too. Plans have kids get waylaid by work. Offered a job at Yale, Yale's in Connecticut. You absolutely do not. Come on, Mayhem. You tell her this means you two won't have a family. She says it's bullshit. She's totally right. She asks if she's taking the job and she will come with her. You say yes. Again, bullshit. But she decides not to take it. Wow, that's different. You might actually play Little Hope this weekend with friends and probably have some screaming audio. Nice. That's cool. Julia is asked to leave Boulder on paid leave after having an episode. She lost out on a colleague for borrowing books that were important to her research. She didn't remember she had happily loaned them to him just 2 days prior. You say that maybe you guys should talk to someone about it. You take Makemaker and drink wine and try to forget about it. It works. You watch Dallas. Dallas. Alright, where are we gonna raid, folks? Got it. So, let's go. Hopefully be back on Tuesday with some Jonah action. I'll put up stuff. Shadow of the Tomb Raider playthrough. And then, yeah, we'll go from there. And probably play that for the next, until we get through the game, you know, of course. And, but for right now, let's go say what's up to, Brian and Amelia, because they are playing the Dark Pictures. And then, yeah, I'll see everybody soon. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you for sharing this great game with me. And, everybody have a good day. Stay safe. Take care of each other, take care of yourselves, and see y'all soon. Alright, folks. Thank you, mods. Thank you, Mooney, Sorrel. Y'all have a good day. And peace out.